Hi everyone, this is GKCS. We are talking about why log appears as many times in complexity analysis. So if you're just starting off and maybe you came around with binary search, you see binary search and you see the order complexity for this algorithm is order log n for the range 0 to n. So this is actually a very interesting result and we'll get to this. But log n is something that we should look at. The next thing is sorting algorithms. And for example, merge sort. The time complexity for this is order n into log of n. Again, interestingly, a wild log n appears. Why is this? Well, log n has an interesting property. In fact, some interesting things have log n as the property. So if I write down a number, let us say 29173, right? What I'm doing is I'm keeping some information in this number implicit. When I'm talking to a human being, 29173 means something. But let's make that explicit. What this is 2 into 10 raised to the power 4. Plus 9 into 10 raised to the power 3, plus 1 into 10 raised to the power 2, plus 7 into 10 raised to the power 1, plus 3 into 10 raised to the power 0. So the implicit information in this is actually the base that you're using. We usually use decimal as our base because it's so common. But computers use binary, and you can use ternary, you can use penta, you can use whatever you like. But the base is important when you're representing information. Of course, you'll notice that the number of digits you need in this number is directly proportional to the maximum exponent that you need of 10 in your number, right? This number is smaller than 10 raised to the power 5. If we call this x, then 10 raised to the power 5 is greater than x. And so what we can say is that the number of digits you need to represent a number in decimal is going to be the maximum exponent slightly greater than the number itself, right? Simply put, easy. That's it. So if I take log of x, okay, to the base 10, this is going to be less than 5. And so slightly greater than x, which is log of 10 raised to the power 5 to the base 10, is equal to 5. And what I can then do is I can just say take the ceiling of log of x to the base 10, and what you'll have with this thing, this number, is the minimum number of digits you need to uniquely identify the number x in the range 0 to x. Right? I want to make that very, very clear. To uniquely identify a number between 0 to, let's say this is 10 raised to the power 5 is n. So from 0 to n minus 1, if I need to uniquely identify a number x, I need log n bits, log n digits basically. Right? In fact, from 0 to x also, of course, it's less than log n digits maybe, but from a range 0 to n minus 1, number of digits you need to uniquely identify a number x is log n. Right? That part is clear because we just proved it taking the largest exponent. Of course, log n to the base 10 is what we talk about when we are talking human language. But for a computer, everything is binary. So log n to the base 2. This number will be represented in binary in log n to the base 2 bits. So this is the reason why log n appears when login bits are required to represent a number. But this also tells us something else. To uniquely identify a number in a given range, 0 to n minus 1, you need login bits. Which means that if I have an array, and I say that I need to search for a value, right? Some value v, and the indexes are from 0 to n minus 1. Essentially what I'm saying is, for this index, for this value actually. Give me an index. I want this value to be mapped to an index, which has some specific property. Basically, I want to find where this value exists. So when I say that, any algorithm will at least take logN operations. And the reason for that is you have a range from 0 to n minus 1 as your indexes. You're searching for one unique index. To identify that, you will need at least logN operations. Very similar to how you can define a number in logN bits. You need at least logN bits to define a number. You need at least logN bits to search for that particular number in this array. Okay? Fine. So take your time. Understand why it's logN, because it's not like you already know the number, you're actually finding it. And every time you're finding it, you're basically taking one digit and choosing a value for that digit. So if this was decimal, then you would have 10 values and you would choose one. So in this case, we would choose 3. And down that path, we would then choose the next choice, which is 7. And in the expanse of 10 raised to the power 6 values, we would be choosing 1 out of 10, then 1 out of the remaining 10, then 1 out of the remaining 10, and so on and so forth. We would be branching. So, of course, visually you can think of it that way, but simply put, you need logN operations for this search, right? You're choosing 1 by 1 by 1, just like you choose digits in this representation. So it takes you logN time. Okay, cool. If you can wrap your head around that, then we have something even tougher. Not really. We are going to be using this result of logN for a search, the best search in the world. It could be binary search, ternary search, whatever you like, penta search. It's going to take you logN. And based on, of course, whether you're doing binary search or ternary search, this base is going to change. But the order won't change. And you can think of that by yourself. There's a video for order complexity that I just made yesterday, so it's there in the description below, and I also keep a card up there. But yeah, have a look at that if you're not sure with order complexities. Okay, now sorting algorithms like merge sort or quick sort, all of them have around n log n worst case time complexity. Technically, quick sort has even more, but yeah, n log n is the time complexity that we usually meet. Why is that? What is sorting actually? Sorting is like taking one array, which is input, right? And the index is from 0 to n minus 1 in this array, because there are n elements. And the output is from 0 to n minus 1. You need to map these elements to this array, right? Each element needs to be mapped to its corresponding index in the sorted array. So, how do we do this? Simply put, if you take any element and try to map its corresponding index in this array, you cannot perform better than the search algorithm you already had, the optimal search algorithm, which is going to take you log n time. Okay, because there are n spots, the range is from 0 to n minus 1. You need to choose one spot. To find that correct spot, it's going to take you at least log n time. So that will be at least log n here. The next element, let's pick this element, has n minus 1 spots to pick from. It will take at least log of n minus 1 time plus log of n minus 2 time for the third element plus so on and so forth up to log of 1, which is 0. Okay, but the important thing here is that there's a property log of A plus log of B is equal to log of A into B. Okay, even if you don't know this, what I can tell you is that it exists. And this whole term then comes out to be log of N into N minus 1 into N minus 2, so on and so forth. So that is log of N factorial. Right, very interesting. Now, we don't know how to break this down. There are some approximations, some good approximations. But let's simplify it even further. N log n is what we are looking for as the worst case. So n minus 1 is definitely less than n. n minus 2 is definitely less than n. I'm going to get rid of these guys, the minus 1, minus 2 factors. And I'm going to make them all n. All of them n. How many times do I need to search for an index? How many terms exist in this? N. So this is going to be n into log of n. That's it. That's it. We have proven that there cannot be a sorting algorithm better than n log n. Okay. Of course, you must be wondering, what is this value? Is it? It's definitely lesser than this. Well, if you do some sort of approximation, what you'll end up with is this value approximates to n log n minus n. But when you take the order complexity, this value is less, I mean, this degree is less than this. So you get rid of minus n and you're left with order n log n. Okay? It might be slightly hard if you're just starting off with algorithms, but intuitive understanding of sorting algorithms and binary search, you can always come back and you can have a look at why the log n factor keeps appearing in computer science. Most important thing, to define, uniquely define a number in a range from 0 to n minus 1, you need n log n bits. Okay, log n digits, log n bits, whatever you like to call it. Then, when you're searching for a number between 0 to n, definitely you need log n operations, because you're defining it as you move ahead. As you search for it, you're actually defining the number. Okay, and because that's the amount taken in a binary search thing, from 0 to n minus 1. Sorting algorithms are nothing but choosing the right index for each element in the sorted array. Right? It's a permutation. It's a permutation of these elements to this point. So the mapping for every element is going to take you at most log n. It's going to take you slightly lesser actually, but at most log n. So for n elements, log n operations, n log n. Okay? And of course, if you're very picky, then you can approximate this to still be order n log n. Okay. If you have any doubts or suggestions, of course, leave them in the comments below. This is slightly heavy for a beginner, so you might want to revisit this, or if you have any suggestions to make it even easier, please leave them in the comments below. I'll see you next time.